Raves and there goes my head shaking. If I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. 'Cause you are the reason. Hi, and welcome to my channel. This is Miss Harmony. So this will be very interesting. I have obtained a copy of Stephan Stern's transport footage. And what I will be doing is I do have the experience for many years, and I will be analyzing Stephan Stern's body language and human behavior during the transporting drive, where he is going to be booked for the sexual battery and possession of a child of sexual abuse material, a total of 60 charges in the Madeline Soto's disappearance death case. So come and learn along with me how to read body language, detect deception, and analyze behavior to help become aware and knowledgeable that can keep yourself and your loved ones safe. Please do not copy this. You may share it only.
I'm gonna make it warm for you, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Can you feel that?
A little bit.
Okay.
So the first thing I noticed is that he is in a black shirt, and it was probably the clothing that he wore when he was arrested. And he's looking around on the ground, and his face is low. And as the sheriff enters the car is when he really gives him a good glare. At this point, the sheriff gets in his car, and he opens up the window, and he asks him about the condition, which is very courteous and very polite thing to do. So, you know, he's trying to make him feel comfortable, hopefully right off the bat, which is what they want them to do.
Trailer I have, that's going as well as happening.
The sheriff is king and Stern is looking very intense, focused directly on what he is doing. It's almost like you see his eyes are all black and he looks very fearful at that point of time.
ALT leaving the jail now. Probably less, sir, because we're taking the turnpike down to 192. So we're taking I-4 to the turnpike. So, I did, sir. I texted him. Yes, sir, he did. Thank you, sir. Bye. How's the temperature feel?
Better than it was.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Don't know why they don't do that. You know, why don't they just kind of like at least give you a blanket, you know?
My core temperature was down. The interpreter was like a degree or two lower than it should have been.
Wow.
Sleeping on bare metal. The first night I was on the concrete floor with a roll of toilet paper for a pillow. Nothing else. Begging for a blanket or a pad to sleep on for like 2 days. I think they were supposed to do stuff like that.
Oof. That sounds rough, man.
When Stephen mentions his sleeping conditions, he feels like his dignity was taken away and does not deserve such. More disgusted by this than why he is going to prison. Thinking if he told the sheriff would acknowledge this is being treated inhumanely. The sheriff's response, "That sounds rough, man." Stephen is hoping he will write this in his transport report. A cunning move he is so good at. I'm not sure if he did. However, I feel that he will bring this up.
Please forgive my cough. I've been trying to get rid of it for the past like 2 or 3 days, and prior to that I had a really bad cold. And you know, I like those, man, but have you ever tried the berry ones? The Ricola berry?
No.
Phenomenal. The Ricola berry ones, they almost taste like candy.
Yeah, be careful with them because the honey ones are the same way.
But once you get to the middle part, it's rough, though. Because, like, it's got a punch. You're talking about the ones that have, like, the it's like a gooey menthol inside of it.
The solid ones are just the honey herb.
So you haven't had the ones that have like the gooey part in the inside? Those are good until you bite into it and you're like, whoa, like it's a burst of like menthol. Yeah, it is. It is. I just got the regular Hall's cherry. It's what I find at 7-Eleven, so.
I've never been one for cherry coffee.
Really?
This tastes too medicinal.
I can't get my kid to drink medicine. I gotta like mix it in his orange juice. For real, I gotta like literally like, here, drink orange juice because it's good for you. It's vitamin C, and you know, because he'll literally like not drink his medicine like at all.
Stern goes quiet in the conversation portion of when the sheriff says, I have to put my daughter's medicine in her orange juice, to see if he would say, I do that also, a confession that would be very valuable to include in his case. We will never obtain the autopsy result due to her age. Makes me wonder if something was in her system for him to begin this conversation. As the drive goes on, Stephen is watching intently outside. He is taking in all he can of the outside world, knowing that this will be his last opportunity for freedom. But in disbelief, he is now going to jail, as he cannot see why. He does not feel any remorse, but only self-pity.
They're not too tight, are they?
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Asked if the cuffs are too tight, he says no, but states that his hand is coming out. You see the sheriff shake his head no, knowing very well he is using a known tactic prisoners will do, and ignores it. Stephen is fiddling with them, with a pouty face, pity me. But in reality, he is not liking that he is confined and has no control of his hands, something important to him for such, that he cannot live that lifestyle that he used to have. How he is going to cope with that.
Ya pasamos la 528, o sea, cerca de Florida Mall. Sí, pero no lo puse, pero yo puedo acelerar. Sí. Sí, pero no vieron. Sí. Pero. Okay, voy de camino. Bye. Gracias. Your body get back to a normal temperature? Yes, sir. What kind of music you like? You like classical music?
Sometimes.
Huh. You're the first person that's ever said classical music. Yeah. Classical. Like what? Like give me like a classical song or You're the first one. I've never had anyone tell me classical music. And I actually like classical music. I do. I've never been to like an orchestra or like a concert like that. I've never been to one. Song, but let's say November Rain, right, by Guns N' Roses. What Slash does with the guitar towards the end of that whole track, he literally makes that guitar cry. Like, it's one of those moments where you're like, wow. I like Metallica. Metallica is my all-time favorite. Queen is, yeah. I haven't seen their latest movie with like the guy that was on the sitcom. I haven't seen the Queen movie yet. I even like Linkin Park. He followed along the same lines as this guy from Soundgarden. I forgot his name. Oh my gosh. And then when he went over to Audioslave, you ever heard Audioslave? I mean, Audioslave came out with like one album and they just crushed it. But classical music, wow. One type of music I never got into was country. I just can't relate to it. I grew up in the city, so not much that I can relate to driving a tractor and stuff like that on some of the songs that I've heard.
I find it very interesting when the sheriff decides to just chit-chat away, and they talk about a lot of things. They talk about music, and he is telling him what he likes, and Stephen's responding, and I noticed that he is really engaging in the conversation. He's feeling more relaxed. He's giving eye contact to the sheriff. We know music is a good conversational piece, but I wonder if the sheriff is probing him what he listens to. as the reason why I say this is, has he seen the videos with maybe perhaps music in it? And B, to help in the investigation, since they may know what's in these videos that he had, that he had played this type of music. He did an excellent job at this, because this will help them in the investigation.
As the investigators have the content that they have seen in his computer, if any of that music is played, will also indicate this could potentially be him, and thus very valuable.
You grew up on a farm?
Yeah.
Wow. But it stinks. Well, why did you work there? Was it like your family's farm? So you're from Georgia?
Sí, está todo bien. Estamos como a dos o tres minutos. Estamos en la 192, casi doblando en la Simpson. Bye. See, I was born in Puerto Rico and then I was raised in Boston. So, it was. I mean, I didn't grow up in Puerto Rico because my mom left there when I was two. And I grew up more in Cambridge in like Boston area. So that was like a big city, you know, projects and that's...
Interesting locals there.
it's definitely different. Definitely different. And then I moved down here, so.
Georgia, Southern California,
San Diego area?
A little further north than that, towards the beach. Somewhere like Newport, you
know. California is nice. I've been there twice. I've been there twice. Yeah, there's no warmth to that water at all.
The sheriff did some interesting tactics to try and get Stearns to talk, engaging him in ridiculous conversation on purpose with a purpose by palling up with him. This is another key portion to help in the investigation. Stephan states of where he was born, where he was raised, and various places that he has gone to, which will help in the investigation. Kudos to the sheriff for doing this.
So once we get here, I gotta go into the interview room and I gotta do the arrest affidavit. Basically, you have two two warrants, so I'll let you know what those are.
I'm going to add the piece of when the sheriff takes Stearns into the booking area so you can see how he is handcuffed. You will notice a belt, and his handcuffs are right to his belt, which is the appropriate thing to do. He might even have shackles on his feet.
Stephan, where's Maddie? Did you hurt her? Are you a pedophile? What's on your cell phone? Why aren't you talking to investigators? Where was Maddie last seen? Why aren't you helping her mother and her family? This is a little girl. Help them find Maddie. Where is Maddie? Where is she? What did you do with her? Tell us something.
So when he was fiddling around, he was, you know, trying to loosen them or something like that. The sheriff picked up on it. I don't know why he was trying to do this, because those types of cuffs with the belt are literally almost impossible to loosen, but it's the intent that he was trying to do something, and we don't know what it was, but luckily nothing ever came out of it. The bottom line look, and everybody probably can see this, is I'm not going home now. But in reality, men like him who have perverted addictions is going to be more concerned about how to get his fix of what he was doing. This would take a long time of therapy, and for him will be extremely hard, as there is really no cure for pedos. He will always remain a risk to society. Being trained in body analyzation is a special technique. You are accessing their cues, whether it may be their eyes, their breathing, their gestures, their hand movements. Basically, you're reading the other person. And the sheriff took this very well in how to communicate with him, just chit-chatting away, randomly on a personal level to make him feel comfortable. And this is a tactic that many people who will deal with criminals will be trained in. For example, when I was doing interviewing techniques, you want the person to be able to feel comfortable and be able to share what their story is.
The bottom line look, and everybody probably can see this, is I'm not going home now. But in reality, men like him who have perverted addictions is going to be more concerned about how to get his fix of what he was doing. This would take a long time of therapy, and for him will be extremely hard, as there is really no cure for pedos. He will always remain a risk to society.
And in making attempts to also perhaps find out information, which he tried to do, as I mentioned in the video. And I am very glad that law enforcement have these special courses that you can now take and upgrade whatever you are going to go into. It is really important to be able to do this, and even a normal person can do this. So I hope you got something out of this. Maybe I didn't catch everything. You can leave in your comments what you thought in some of the cues that Stern was using.